Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding elections are not referendum written by Meera Chandok. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 4. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the upcoming elections in the state of Goa, Manipur, Punjab and Uttar Pradesh are being projected as the referendum on demonetization. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand the difference between election and referendum. Election or referendum make that difference. Secondly, we need to understand what is democracy. Democracy. Now we will be discussing democracy from the perspective of this editorial, because it is important to understand the basic concepts again and again in order to get a proper meaning out of the editorial. Now first of all, what is the difference between election and referendum? Now referendum is always conducted on one issue. Referendum is about asserting what the people really want to choose from a situation. लोग क्या चाहते हैं एक पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन से, रेफरेंडम इसलिए कंडक्ट कराया जाता है. रेफरेंडम एट द फेस इट लुक्स टू बी अ पार्ट नॉट ऑफ द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव डेमोक्रेसी बट डेलिबरेटिव डेमोक्रेसी, बट इन एसेंस इट इज नॉट डेलिबरेटिव डेमोक्रेसी. रेफरेंडम को हमेशा प्रोजेक्ट किया जाता है कि रेफरेंडम इज लाइक अ डेलिबरेटिव democracy, where people are directly participating in the decision making process. But this thing is not correct, because the kind of the choices that the people make during a referendum, they are actually not the informed choices. So the keyword here is informed choices. The choices made by the people are not the rational choices. The keyword here is rational. Now the choices made by the people are not the choices by going into the nitty gritties of the issues. People are less informed about the issues. People lack the long vision. People cannot interpret the subtleties that are attached with a particular issue. And this is the reason why we have the system of representative form of government. Then representative form of government, we elect representatives. It is the job of these representatives, it is the profession of these representatives to deliberate on the issues, to come out with exact laws, to come out with the rational laws. It is the duty of these people to come out with laws by making them pass through the parliament. Now any law that is made, it has been tried, the winds and the pressures of the accountability and of control. Now, कोई भी कानून जो पास होता है वो trials and tribulations से पास होता है. जब भी कोई बिल पेश किया जाता है पार्लियामेंट में, उसके ऊपर इनडेप्थ डिस्कशन होती है, उसके ऊपर कंट्रोल मैकेनिजम्स लगते हैं, उसके अगेंस्ट अगर ऑपोजिशन को लगता है कि ये गलत है, नो कॉन्फिडेंस मोशन पास किया जाता है सरकार के खिलाफ. So such kind of tools are used in order to exert accountability and control from the government. But such things are not present in referendum. Now this election, the upcoming election in the states of Manipur, UP, Goa and Uttar Pradesh is being projected as a referendum on demonetization. Now such an act on the part of the BJP, such an act on the part of the government is not right. Now why it is not right? Because election has a wider meaning attached with it. There are specific issues of the specific states which matter the most. Now take the case of Punjab. Punjab is reeling under drug cartelization. Punjab is reeling under deterioration of agriculture. Punjab is reeling under huge unemployment. Punjab is reeling under the issue whereby the coffers of the government has really dried up. There is a huge fiscal deficit of the Punjab government. फिस्कल डेफिसिट बहुत ज्यादा है पंजाब की गवर्नमेंट का, ड्रग्स का बहुत प्रॉब्लम है, एग्रीकल्चर बहुत ज्यादा खराब हो चुका है. तो दीज आर द रियल इश्यूज विच द इलेक्शन शुड बी एड्रेसिंग. दीज आर द इश्यूज ऑन विच द पीपल शुड बी वोटिंग अप. सो द इलेक्शन ऑल टूगेदर हैज अ डिफरेंट मीनिंग. डीमोनेटाइजेशन इज नॉट द मैजिक वैंड that will result in eradicating all the problems. It's not a magic wand that will do away with all the pains that the Punjab is reeling under. Demonetization is not a stroke of the genius that will help to do away with the problems that Uttar Pradesh is facing, that Manipur is facing, that Goa is facing. It is just one part of the policy. And moreover, demonetization has already been introduced. Demonetization cannot be a policy on which the referendum should be conducted, because referendum is usually conducted on such policies which are yet to be implemented. But the demonetization has already been implemented, and the effects of the demonetization will come after a year or 2 years. Moreover, the recent World Bank's report on India's growth rate has highlighted an important point, that the growth rate of Indian economy, it will be cut by about 0.5 to 1%. And after that, there are chances that the economy might grow. So there are a lot of mays and mights in the report of World Bank. Even World Bank is not sure about what is going to be the outcome of demonetization. So conducting referendum on such is not the right thing. Election altogether has a very sagacious meaning attached with it. Now coming to democracy. When it comes to democracy, democracy is about the participation of the people in the right manner. Democracy is not asserting majoritarianism. Now when it comes to referendum don't have the mechanisms of accountability and control attached with it. आपने यस बोल दिया, आपने नो बोल दिया किसी पॉलिसी को लेके रेफरेंडम में. रेफरेंडम में आप डेलिबरेट नहीं कर सकते. सो रेफरेंडम इज अ वेरी शैलो कंसेप्ट इन कंपैरिजन टू इलेक्शंस. रेफरेंडम इज अ स्यूडो डेमोक्रेसी. रेफरेंडम इज फंडामेंटलिज्म. रेफरेंडम इज मेजोरिटेरियनिज्म. रेफरेंडम इज नॉट द राइट वे टू कंडक्ट डेमोक्रेसी. इट्स अ रॉन्ग वे टू कंडक्ट द डेमोक्रेसी. Referendum may project the will of the people, and we can never know whether that particular will was well guided or it was less guided, whether it had a base of rationality or not behind it. Now from examination point of view, the question that you will get on this critically analyze the difference between election and referendum. And with respect to India, which is the tool that we should be mostly resorting to? किस टूल को ज्यादा यूज करना चाहिए, इलेक्शंस को ज्यादा यूज करना चाहिए या रेफरेंडम को ज्यादा यूज करना चाहिए? नाउ इफ यू वांट टू रीड मोर ऑन दिस, विजिट brainias.com. यू कैन आल्सो इंस्टॉल अवर एप्लीकेशन. नेम ऑफ द एप्लीकेशन इज brainias. यू कैन फाइंड दिस एप्लीकेशन फ्रॉम गूगल प्ले स्टोर एंड फ्रॉम ऐप स्टोर. सो दिस वाज ऑल फॉर द डे. बाय बाय, टेक केयर, हैव अ नाइस डे.